You make me feel like I'm... Gentlemen and ladies, ladies and gents, we're going to be playing a little bit of Adele in the background. And so you're going to be hearing a little bit of wind in the background. Just so that you know, ladies and gentlemen, you guys have been hearing a little rumbling in the speakers when I'm talking. That's because I have the windows open. Because, like I said, we get a breeze at least 4 times during the day. It's consistent. It's every single day. I have not had a day where we haven't had breezes coming through the window. So I got the front door closed. 3 windows open. Only 3. No, 4. 4 windows open in each of the directions, except for south, because the wind is blowing to the south. And ladies and gentlemen, it's comfortable on this 87 degree day. So let's just say I'm adjusting to my environment. Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies, ladies and gents, I want to thank you all for the contributions. We're now at 90%. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I do appreciate that. It has helped tremendously. Without it, I would not have been able to accomplish what I've been able to accomplish. So thank you. I say that because it's necessary. I wanted to take the time to explain something because I thought it was somewhat necessary. Ladies and gentlemen, there are people who listen to the videos, and some of them, they have an opinion. They think they know me because they've listened to so many videos. And I understand the logic. I really do. But there are a lot of things people don't know, because you're not going to find it in any paper. You're not going to find it in any court case. You're not going to find it in any video, because I'm not going to discuss it. Now, what am I talking about? Mama, what's he talking? No. Just so that it's understood, because it's not easy talking to people about yourself.
Oh, you love talking about yourself. That's all you do is talk about yourself. I mean, every time I listen to a video, it's all you're doing is talking about you. Oh, you just talk about yourself just way too... Oh, God, it's too much.
And see, thus, it's because of the ignorance that it doesn't happen. You see, everybody has an opinion. Now, videos, 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 videos. We can do videos all day long. We can do 100,000 videos. Those of us who take the time to do the videos and expend of our energy. It isn't easy, people. Sometimes, as I told you, it would take 7-8 hours just to produce a video. Now, there are some people who, that's their living. They make a living doing nothing but videos and begging for donations. That is not this man right here. Now, if you really, really want to get a better understanding of who I am, go and look at the videos and see how much people have benefited from those videos. Just go. I beg you. Go look at the videos and look at the amount of information that's contained in the videos. And then look at the amount of benefit that has come to people as a result of those videos. That's what I'm here to do. I'm here to not educate people. That's not my job. Your job is to educate yourself. My job is to, hey, here's the information. It's right over there. No. Right. No, you look at, no, right. There you go. That's where, okay. Yeah. And once you finish with that, then I'll show you where the rest of the information is. Because it's not all right there. They have it in other places. You see, that's me. My job is to point things out to you. Okay. For instance, I've been wanting to talk about this for weeks. You notice how they've been talking about a lot of cybersecurity now. There's a breach here and a breach there. Well, you notice that we've had breaches all the time. So what is so important about all of these breaches lately? I mean, we've had a breach every 5 seconds of the day. They've been breaching everything. And you notice how they're using it as an excuse? What do I mean by an excuse? Well, at first they claimed the breach into that facility that did refinery and transported gasoline around the country in certain areas of the country. Well, that's what caused gas prices to go up. Now, it got breached on a Friday, and by the time Monday came around, gas prices had already shot up more than 50 cents a gallon. I just paid $4.
$4.30
a gallon here in California. $4.30. $4.30.
I ain't never paid no $4.30 for no stupid gasoline.
Gasoline ain't made out of no gold. Ladies and gentlemen, Adele is going to be talking about somebody like me. Okay, in my background. Y'all know how we got it, you know. That's Adele, everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, gas prices. What you don't know, and I do want you to do your research. Gas prices are set months in advance. 2 months in advance on average. So how is something that happened last week going to affect gasoline today? Impossible. But suckers will believe what suckers will believe. Takes a sucker to learn. Now, let's see how I can explain this so that you all will get it. The so-called government gave people what is called stimulus. Now, we know there is no money, but there is accounting. Pay attention. There may not be money, but there is accounting. And their system is a system of accounting. Okay? That's all it is. Well, ladies and gentlemen, they did not raise taxes.
You're right, they didn't raise taxes, they lowered taxes.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're so misled. They did raise taxes. They just didn't call it a tax hike, but they did raise taxes.
How did they raise taxes? They lowered the taxes on all of the businesses and everything. So how do they raise taxes if they lowering taxes?
Ladies and gentlemen, you're right. They did lower the taxes on the businesses. They did. They lowered the taxes on the businesses. So now, during the whole summer, you all are paying higher gas prices. Now, what's the biggest cost in paying for gas? Is it not the federal taxes that they put on it? They gave you a stimulus, and they raised gas prices? Now, remember, to make up for the taxes that they gave the rich people, the businesses, the corporations, guess what they did? Follow me, people. Because some of you have not been paying attention. They raise taxes on imports from China. The majority of consumer goods is from China, everybody, made in China. Well, when they raise the import taxes on the goods coming from China, the manufacturers in China have to pass those import taxes on to consumers like you. Which means you're paying more for the products you're buying. Which means that's a tax hike. Okay? Just thought I'd explain it to you because a lot of people are not getting it. They can't put the math together. Now look, if this is too much for you, if you can't understand the depth of the information that's just being stated, I apologize. I apologize that you simply... Everybody wants to be in the know. Everybody wants to say they're enlightened. They're awakened. And yet they don't understand the basics. It's a shame. Ladies and gentlemen, I was speaking with someone today. And they made mention that they had paid attention to certain videos and certain key phrases that I had placed in the videos. And it's not the first person that brought this to my attention. And they are correct. There are certain keys and clues in certain videos regarding certain topics that are meant for the people who are a little bit more advanced than others. I joke with you not. I kid you not. The reason why I'm mentioning it, because those individuals understood so much that they understood, that they've mentioned it to me on occasion, and one person, as of today, mentioned it to me. Ladies and gentlemen, from time to time, I say, yes, there's information in the videos. That's why I even suggest those who listen to the videos that if you stay to the end, you might get something that everybody else is not going to get. See, the average time people listen to videos, it's about 5.5 minutes, because that's their attention span. Ladies and gentlemen, that does say a lot about a person. If all you have is an attention attention span of 5 to 10 minutes, then that shows a lack of,
I've been quite sick to take you back to the
Jedi. That shows a lack of intelligence. There is no other word for it. You see, you don't have the mental capacity to take in information longer than 5 minutes. That means that your mind can't handle information in excess of 5 minutes worth of attention pay. It's not your fault. Well, technically it is your fault, but it's not your fault. Because that's what society has done to you. Do you know they used to have hour-long sitcoms? And then they went from hour-long sitcoms to 30-minute sitcoms. And they actually coined it with the phrase 30-minute sitcom. And that's what people would do. They'd go from one 30-minute sitcom to another 30-minute sitcom. Why would they go from one sitcom? Oh, and that's why they give you commercials every 7.5 minutes. No. Pay attention! They give you commercials every 7.5 minutes, not because they're trying to sell you on something, but they know that they lose you after 5.5 minutes. But if they gave you a commercial every 5.5 minutes, you would get tired of the interruptions and you would not watch. So every 7.5 minutes, that's why every hour-long show, pay attention, every hour-long show, it's 42 minutes. But it's an hour-long show. So why are they giving it to you and giving you 18 minutes of interruption for 60 minutes? Divide 18 into 60, people. See what you get. Go ahead. I'll wait. Do you understand? That's what they're doing to you. They're giving you the commercials because their attention span can't handle it. See, that's why the people who are binge-watching, who will watch a whole series, and it'll take them a week to get through a 8-season series. Okay, those are the people they're not interested in. That's why they don't want you guys downloading shows. They definitely don't want you downloading your own programs. How dare you? You're taken away from their revenue, and they want their revenue. They need their revenue. Okay, they want to get paid, and those of you who are sitting up there taking shortcuts, they're not going to let you do that too often. So I just want to prepare y'all, just be ready. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have the fact that they gave these stimulus payments, they call them, to people. Now, what nobody's paying attention to, the moratorium on mortgages and people making mortgage payments, why didn't they do that? Why didn't they put the stimulus money towards the people who were about to default on their mortgages like they should have done in 2008 when the so-called crisis happened? Why didn't they do that? Well, the reason why they didn't do that is because they couldn't. They need you in debt. They need you scrounging. They need you scrapping. They need you sitting up there begging and pleading for mercy. They need you to beg for assistance, for help. Why? Because, ladies and gentlemen, that's how government operates. Government is there to make the people dependent on it. You guys know this? I'm not giving you information that you don't already know. So because they got you wrapped around fingers, and because that's their job is to keep you wrapped around their fingers, because they got you wrapped around their finger, they can keep you in place. They can keep you on lockdown. Okay? Because that's the way it works. Want to make they need you being cards, dependent. Oh, together? Let me show you something else that you guys may not have noticed. Have you ever watched a YouTube video and a commercial came on? Yeah, I know. There's an app called SkipVid. I haven't started it on this, but I am going to start it on this. I'm going to skip one of Adele's songs. Ladies and gentlemen, skip ad works. Okay, also, YouTube VADSED, V-A-N-C-E-D, short for advance, but YouTube VADSED. If you can find a copy of YouTube VADSED, download it on your cell phone and download it on your computer, never have to watch another YouTube commercial. Yeah, YouTube hates YouTube Vance. They probably have an algorithm that listens for people saying YouTube Vance. Okay? But YouTube Vance, that will get you around the commercials if you really hate commercials like I do. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, you know that little ticker that ticks down when you're watching YouTube? It goes 5 seconds. Well, no, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah. See, that was the presumption that that's seconds. It's actually not seconds. Because that actually takes 7 seconds. It's not seconds. That's a distraction. Because it never said seconds. The other commercials that tells you your commercial, I mean your whatever will begin in 6 seconds, 5 seconds, 4, that's seconds. It actually tells you it's seconds. But that other thing does not say seconds. It just counts down. Yeah, that's the gimmick of Google. Because they have you thinking that you're waiting for something when technically you're not waiting for anything. You're just waiting. Okay? There you go. A lot of this stuff is going on. And because a lot of it is going on, people are not paying attention. Right now, Google and everybody is tracking everything you do and they're asking for permission to track you. You can opt out, but because there's so many different companies and you're engaging with so many different organizations, opting out of everything is a headache. That's why states like California have these new laws where you have to opt in. That's why I'm told the new Apple is supposed to have a setup to where you are supposed to opt in and not have to opt out of everything. I kind of appreciate stuff like that because that right there is, yeah, that's a positive. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen and ladies and gents, I don't want to keep you guys for too long. I just wanted to let you know that everything with this person is okay. Got a lot of things I'm working on, caught up with all the arbitrations that needed to be done. Now look, many of you are not understanding the arbitration game. Many of you have been disheartened to it because
I'll pay $500
and I just want you to understand that we're getting ready to go before the Supreme Court. I have to be patient. See, we've had several cases before several appeals courts, and they are ignoring us. We paid the filing fee. They are ignoring us. So I want you to understand, I have to be patient. I cannot call in and haggle them and yell at them and scream at them. I cannot do that. Why? Because it ain't that type of party, ladies and gentlemen. That's what they want you to do. Technically, you're not supposed to be calling the court at all. You're not supposed to be speaking to anybody over the telephone. Everything should be in writing. Okay, you can't accomplish anything by calling somebody on some stupid phone. They are not going to respond to you the way that they're supposed to respond to you. You're not going to get the answer you're looking for. Because that's their system. That's how their system
small
works.
Business owner, it's easy it's to feel alone sometimes.
A stupid system
add,
at that.
You should definitely add that
so,
to your contract. Fortunately,
what I can't explain what the strategy is because they're listening. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't believe they listen to the videos, God, you have another thing coming. Okay? They're trying to prepare themselves for when I tell you guys to do something or tell you guys about something or suggest something. They're trying to prepare themselves so that they can sit up there and create roadblocks. That's why I've been emphasizing, ladies and gentlemen, you have to learn the rules. Once you understand what the rules are, then you can navigate the game. So my hope is that many of you will start to go over the rules of the court for accessing the court. You don't really need to know the rules about a motion. A motion is nothing but a letter. Now, I do have a lot of people who claim I don't know anything about the law. I know it's stupid and ignorant. No, let me tell you something. What I have is a hatred for the tricks, the presumption of law. Courts are supposed to be venues of facts and truth. Well, there is no truth in the courtroom, not the modern day courtroom. Especially when a judge gets to lie, and prosecutors get to lie, and defense attorneys get to lie. Anytime someone gets to lie in a court of law, when it is a violation of law to put false information on a public record, that lets you know that it is a fake system. Sorry, it's just the way it is. Just the way it is. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so that you know, what my suggestions have been to everybody is for them to get to know the rules of the court, to follow the law, to follow the rules, to follow procedure. There will be people out there who will say that I have been doing completely the opposite. And I'm not going to interfere with them saying ignorant, stupid, moronic things. They can say whatever they want. But I know that all of the ones who pay attention to me know that I don't advocate anything but truth. Follow the rules. Follow their policy. Follow their procedure. And everything works out. Yeah. Even if they say you did this or you did that and you know you didn't do this or you didn't do that, if you follow through, ladies and gentlemen, everything works out. We have one case where I've been writing to court and they've been ignoring us. We paid the filing fee, sent them $500 twice, and they still haven't processed our filing. So, well, that's because somebody was suing us, and like I told you, we challenge, we communicate back. We say, oh, what the y'all think y'all doing? That's what we do. We speak up. We hey, what y'all doing? Y'all can't do that. That's what we do. Okay? And they go, oh, no, we can do whatever we want. You don't understand, fool. You don't get to do that here. You get to do that with them other fools. You don't get to do that with us. Because we ain't gonna play that. You can get other people to play that, but not over here. We don't play that over here. Okay, so y'all need to slow your roll. That's what we do, ladies and gentlemen. We respond. Now, we are sorry that many of you who had cases with the court that we couldn't come in and speak up for you. The unique thing is many of those cases we didn't even know they added our name as a corporation. They never served us. They will claim that they did, but they did not serve us, because every time they served us, we've responded. So the fact that we couldn't come in to each person's rescue is because there were too many. See, what they were trying to do is bring so many lawsuits against us to where our hands were tied, to where we had to pay for an attorney here, then had to pay for an attorney there, then had to pay for an attorney there. Not gonna happen. They were trying to run us out of money. They were trying to bankrupt us. And we decided that, nah, we're not gonna do that. So we chose the ones where they said that there was no contract, when we had proof that the other party received the contract. Once you make a determination that there's no contract, when the law says only the arbitrator gets to determine whether or not there's a contract. Now, whether or not there's an agreement between the parties, as long as the contract has an arbitration clause, that's the arbitration decision. That is not the court decision. So what the court was doing is the court was saying, I don't care what y'all think. Y'all ain't doing it that way. Y'all gonna do it the way we say. And we're telling the court, you must be out of your mind. You don't control arbitration. You never controlled arbitration. That's your problem. That's why you guys are so pissed off, because you can't control arbitration. You have no control. You have no custody. You have no jurisdiction over arbitration. They want to have jurisdiction over arbitration. They want to control arbitration. They want to make sure that arbitration is only done by them and controlled by them. And we're saying, keep trying. Good game. You played a good game. It was an interesting battle. But, sorry, no go. Not here. Don't get to play that one. Alright? So, ladies and gentlemen, the new contracts, let me say this again, the new contracts that are up on SAA has a more comprehensive arbitration clause. So more comprehensive arbitration section. Why? Because it covers all of the arguments the courts have been bringing thus far. The same thing they do to us. They wait for us to have an argument, and then they try to cancel, kill our argument. So what we're doing is we're saying the same thing. We're bringing forth our arguments to cancel their arguments based upon their arguments. We're doing the same thing to them that they've done to us. will say to you, my YouTubers, yeah, that's the best way I can put it for now. What we're saying to you is, hold on. Don't give up. If you have an arbitration agreement, we've already showed you where the tax credits are permissible and allowable. Okay? So don't give up. What we need for you to do is to understand you have every right to enter into a contractual agreement with government agents. And so, I do want to let you guys know, some of you guys think you're smarter. Some of you guys think that you're too smart. So, let me help you out so that you guys get it. What's happening is that some of you have decided to rewrite the contract completely and thinking that the arbitration section is too much. You've taken it out. And then you come and you apply for an arbitration hearing. Ladies and gentlemen, without an arbitration clause, there can be no arbitration hearing. We received several contracts that were done that way. Even had one guy that was arguing with us. Arguing. Trying to tell us, now hold on. He trying to tell us that we didn't know what we were doing. Looking at his contract and it didn't have an arbitration clause. And if we had allowed, one of the arbitrators failed to observe that there was an arbitration clause. And if we had allowed that to stand, then the courts really could have come after us for collusion and fraud and conspiracies and all that other stuff. We weren't going to let that happen. Not on this planet. No way on this planet was I going to permit our company to be put. And when I say our company, the company that I founded, it's not my company anymore. That company has been completely turned over. Why? Because they did the work. They kept it afloat while I was on vacation. So they proved trustworthy. See, that's the unique thing about me. You know, I work with people who prove themselves trustworthy. And once they prove themselves trustworthy, then that's all she wrote. Literally, that's all she wrote. That's all I need to hear. That's all I need to see. Now, no one has gotten over on anybody. Nobody has taken money out of anybody's pocket.
Get your head out of my pocket!
No, I'm sorry. Nobody has done anything like that. Why can and how can I say that? Because we have an accounting department. We do the taxes. We go over every receipt. Okay? Let me let you all know this. We've had some people who have indulged themselves, but they've hurt themselves in the long run because they lose out on the tax credit issue. Now, we've already did the video showing you guys how we have the ability, the right to sit up there and give tax credits to individuals who are, what we say, investors. The law permits it. And so, what we have done is we have brought this to everybody's attention, and that's the direction we're going to head. We have to finish taking care of the research on such things. Okay, there is a set of research that needs to be done, that must be done, and we're taking care of that now. Okay, so just be patient with me as I get around to taking care of the most important things first. Then we will take care of your tax credits by the end of the year. The reason why I gave myself until the end of the year is because I knew that I would be distracted over these next couple of months. I know for a fact that I'm going to be distracted over the next couple of months. So to keep me from making promises to people and then having to break my promises, because you know how that is, ladies and gentlemen, something comes up and you go, oops, I'm sorry. Okay, I don't want there to be many oops, I'm sorry. I want there to be, hey guys, this is what we're working on now. We've done this, we've done that, and we just have this to do. That's what I want to be able to say to you. So please bear with me. I appreciate that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I never want you all to mind. This has been an interesting trip, and we have a lot more work to do. So buckle your seatbelts. Those of you who have not, I want to say this because it is necessary. Those of you who have not taken care of your contracts, we talked about getting grandfathered in, if you don't think that we've caused enough stir in the system, if you don't think that they're pissed off at us, then you got problems. Okay, remember, what they did to me, as illegal as it was, they did as a result of the arbitrations. Just want you to pay attention. They didn't do it for any other reason. That lets you know how powerful the arbitrations are. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if the arbitrations are that powerful, then you all need to get your contracts done. You don't have to get the arbitration done. You just need to get the contract established. Now, starting in July 1st, SAA will start sending the contracts out for you. Okay? And because they'll be sending the contracts out, they won't be the arbitrator. It will be a different organization. But because of that, I need all of you to understand, it will be July 1st, not January. So it'll be July 1st that will take place. And when that happens, I do need all of you to pay attention to how that's going to work out. I now see why it's been nothing but a Dale, because this is a sort of like a playlist. And, yeah, I kind of think Adele is all right, but we don't need all Adele, not right now. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to another playlist on YouTube. Okay, this is Amy, okay, in my background. Ladies and gentlemen, we just need all of you to brace yourselves, because there's going to be a change. Just take my word for it. They can't stop the arbitrations. The court cannot stop the appeals, because our appeals are based upon the law, based upon fact. It's not based upon procedural grounds or anything like that. No, it's based upon the fact that arbitrators are immune. As long as the arbitrator followed the contract, it doesn't matter if the court says there's no contract. That's not the court's job. The arbitration, the Federal Arbitration Act says that it's up to the arbitrator. Acting without jurisdiction, and we had every right to challenge the jurisdiction of the court, for which at no point did they pay attention to our challenge. We have a case right now where this company tried to jump into a lawsuit as a party to the lawsuit, some stupid attorney, and when he tried to jump in, the court said, no, you can't jump in, because what did I do? I had already pointed out to the court that it was too late for anybody to come into the case. See, they're reading everything I'm putting into the records. I don't put affidavits. But they're reading every affidavit. They're just not responding to the affidavit directly. They're responding to them indirectly. I don't care. That's why I write them the way I write them. They see I'm trying to put certain things on the record so I can come back later and say, we brought this to the court's attention. Not a judicial officer. No. The court, the thing that's supposed to be honorable. We brought it to the court's attention, and the court ignored the law. See, that's what we do. We go after the court. Then later, we go after their bonds. Ladies and gentlemen, I promise you, I'm going after bonds. I could care less about the actual institution. I'm going after the bond. I want them to violate my rights. I want to document the violation of rights, just like I'm doing here in California. I've already filed with the Risk Management Department for the state government. That was done in November. I'm just waiting for time to go by to get to ignore me so that I can sue the insurance company. That's right, you heard me. I'm not going to sue the state. The state's going to claim immunity. And I don't want to have to argue they don't have immunity. I don't want to have to argue they're a corporation or involved in commerce. No. I don't want to do all that. No, I want to sue the insurance company for denying my claim without cause. For not doing any investigation, for not communicating, for nothing. For ignoring a valid claim. And I'll bring forth my claim against the insurance company for ignoring the valid claim and not for what the initial issues were. Because why should I have to deal with the initial issues? Why should I have to argue that? I've already proven those points. All right, ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies, that's me bringing this to you all's attention. Now, what I'm going to do is, because I'm doing this on my tablet, we need to let y'all get on about y'all business. I'm going to go ahead and end this video. It's 7:57 p.m.
So I's gotta go, okay? Y'all take care of yourselves. And y'all come on back now. I'll speak to you all later. Have a good day, have a good night, have a good life, have a good time. Hey, it's gonna be alright. Gotta go.